6 months in Redondo. Beach right by the condo. Oh my gosh, oh my kase. I'ma need my sushi pronto. Shooting star like a Cosmo. Make you move like a mambo. Spank a hater like a bongo. They be sleeping mano. Girl sweet like a mango.
Ah, fine Sunday here in the City of Angels, Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend series between the Washington Nationals and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Alongside Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesak, and guys, the Dodgers are looking to break out the Blues here at home.
No doubt, they will be absolutely focused. You want to steal a sweep from your rivals any chance you can. And I got to be honest, this is probably bigger for the fans than the players playing in this one. Huge bragging rights at stake.
Danny Duffy starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. Here now is Juan Soto. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Here comes the 1-2. Right side and right into the shift. Reined in. Throw on to Muncy. Gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Nationals gone in order. The Dodgers coming up, and we are scoreless. Josiah Gray will do the pitching in game three of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
It's not an easy thing to do to pitch as a rookie, but one of the things you have to do is use the positives. The opposing team has never faced you. You can't be afraid to throw the ball into the strike zone. Establish your pitches and try to work quickly.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ripped down the first baseline. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Bases are empty. One man out. And it's belted high and deep into right center.
Go on, go two.
And
go two,
oh, he missed
two,
a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. The relay throw. And he's out at third. Might have gotten a little greedy that time.
You talk about perfect execution right there. That took a great relay throw to get him. And any breakdown in that relay, and I think he's safe.
Carter Kieboom digs in now. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Strike called. Now the throw down. Is not close as he's in there with a stolen base.
We all know this team is struggling right now. They're on a losing streak. So when that's the case, sometimes you need to be a little bit more aggressive and try to put some pressure on your opponents. Stolen bases are a good way of doing that. So we'll see if it pays off on the scoreboard for him right now.
Ready with the 0-1. Hit out towards second. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. And now here is James Newcomb. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, and he certainly got the wheels trying to stretch a double into a triple. But it's sort of a killer to the club when you can't leg it out.
Liner toward right center. And this is going to find the alley as he might have himself his second double of the ballgame. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. And not in time as the run scores. Just an absolute laser that time. Screaming off the bat, if you will. And ShowTrack tells us it went out at 112 miles an hour. Those are the line drives you can hear as they go by. Out in front here is this one scorched foul to the left. Today's contest is, of course, the finale of the series, and the Dodgers have really dominated so far. They've got the chance to complete a sweep with a win in this one.
You know, and it's not an easy thing to complete a sweep, particularly in this day and age where the games and the teams are so competitive, so a sweep at home would be extra special.
Here's the 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to
left. Come on, dig, 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 go hard.
I got it, I got it.
Hernandez finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. A run, a hit, and a man left. Three innings complete. Dodgers lead this one 2-1. Digging in next, James Newcomb. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Sent on the ground out to second. Fielded cleanly, and there are two away now. It's a runner at first with two men out. And here's Lane Thomas into the box. 0-1 delivery. He's running. Pitch inside. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
90 feet is a big deal when you're talking about a one-run game. So that's a little risky. But, hey, sometimes you have to be aggressive and force the other team to stop you.
Stepping up is James Newcomb. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
The 0-1 on its way. Back for the out, but meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Luis Garcia.
Rarely do you see a closer come in when you have a comfortable lead like this one here. We'll see if he's able to keep his concentration. A lot of times, closers have a difficult time when they have that lead of three or more runs.
Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. So next to hit is number three. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Hey, you got one.
The 0-1. A swing and a ground ball to third. Turner loves it to second for one. On to first, and he rolls a double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
Man, I don't care who you roll out there against these guys. That's 10 wins in a row for them. So they feel like they could beat anybody in the league right now. And they're making it look awfully easy, too.
5-1, the final total in today's game. Los Angeles led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Danny Duffy takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. So that'll do it for us. Tuesday night baseball here on the show from Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Tonight we begin a new homestand with the first of three between the Colorado Rockies and the Los Angeles Dodgers. The Dodgers enter the day with their winning streak of 10 games. They'll try to extend it next. Max Scherzer gets the start for Los Angeles in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny? Next to stand in is James Newcomb.
The second baseman.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. line towards center field. And that'll get down for a base hit. Long throw to third. Throw won't get him.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Kept his shoulders square, his hands inside the baseball, and was able to fight off a good, nice executed pitch for a knock.
Batting four. The catcher.
Strike three called, and now he's one out away from getting out of this.
Well, their chances of pushing across a run took a pretty good hit after that strikeout. It's so much tougher to score a guy from third with two outs instead of one. Basically, you need a hit, or you need to get lucky with a wild pitch or a pass ball.
Pitch misses low. The throw down. Not nearly in time as he took that one on the pitcher.
That's a great call from the dugout to put the runner in motion that time. With two outs and a good hitter at the plate, it's a pretty low-risk play. If he's out, you still got the same good hitter leading off the next inning. But if he's safe, he's in scoring position and a lot easier to drive in.
Now a high fly ball headed for the corner in left. It has the distance and nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one. And just
we'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Trying to make it a 2-0 ball game by bringing home that runner from third. Here's the first pitch to him. Line drive to center field. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And not in time as the run scores.
Well, that wasn't your standard sack fly hit. It was hit pretty low and hard, so it wasn't a given they were going to send it. But they did.
One out, base is empty, and that will bring up the big first baseman, C.J. Krohn. Sent on the ground out to second. Scooped up on the first, and Scherzer's on a roll now, two away. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that will bring in the second baseman, James Newcomb. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Hey, I'm surprised he went to that spot in his zone. This guy's known for being a down and in hitter. Don't expect too many pitches going in that spot.
Line hard toward right center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And it's a good start to the inning for the Dodgers on the leadoff double.
You could tell he was thinking fastball all the way here, and that's exactly what he got. He was able to get the bat hit out front and pull it into the gap at the right center. Now they're set up pretty nicely for a good inning after that leadoff double.
Now that, the catcher.
Good late break to the slider. 87 on the gun there. It's 1-2.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
The 1-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Getting a few steps off the second there. Now the pitch.
And it
gets him on the mound. But he is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now. And now they'll hustle out there and attend to their pitcher. And that was quite a shot he took, as you see him down on a knee. But if there's one thing I know about this guy, he will not want to come out of this game. And from all indications, it looks like he's going to try to continue. Now to the plate, A.J. Pollock. Hit in two tries for him so far. Into the corner and slicing foul. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Here comes manager Bud Black out of the dugout heading for the mound. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So he'll make his way to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, and he just didn't have his best stuff in the front. Blackman is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And he's not even going to consider it here as he holds tight at third with two away now. Next up is Max Muncy. Comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 1-1 home.
Hey, let's go right here. Let's go.
He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. Racing back the left fielder. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. So a three-run blast to straightaway left. Sixth home run on the season for him. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
And if you remember the previous pitch, he couldn't get around on a fastball and was mad at himself. Well, there's nothing to be mad about anymore, unless you're the guy standing on the mound wondering what to do.
Now at the plate here is James Newcomb. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. First pitch on the way. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. He'll whip this one first in time, and that ends the inning. Elias Diaz the next to hit. Past battles with Scherzer, just a 1-for-9. Hit out towards second. He's right there. On to first, and it's a quick start to the seventh as now there are two away.
Well, I know you don't want to jinx it by talking about it, but this streak now, it's up to 11 games. When you're playing this well, you think the good times are going to last forever. But in baseball, trust me, this game has a way of humbling you. They should enjoy this ride, though, while it lasts.
An 8-0 shutout this evening. Los Angeles led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Max Scherzer notches his third win of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Here now is our final line.
Wednesday night baseball now from Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the Colorado Rockies and the Los Angeles Dodgers. The Dodgers enter today's matchup with an 11-game winning streak on the line. They'll try to notch their 12th straight next. A.J. Pollock, his prior history versus this arm. He's hitless in three at-bats. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Oh, and this one's driven the other way and deep to the corner. Almost into the short porch, but it's off the wall. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Nothing fires me up more than watching an offensive player stay inside a baseball and drive it the other way.
Second baseman.
And it's fouled away. Pollock, the runner at second with one away.
Here we go, guys. Hey, stay hot now. Nobody back. Nobody back.
fouled off. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. In the dirt here. Crow goes to third. Right there, and he is out trying to take third. Next up is number 9. Worked a walk his first time up. Line toward the alley in left center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. This will kick up against the wall now. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Two down with a runner at first. And that will bring up A.J. Pollock. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Line to the right side. In there,
yeah,
base
grounded,
hit.
Grounded. Find the ball.
The hold at second, and there are two aboard now.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Now back, second baseman.
It's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
2-1, here it is. A little bouncer. Betts over at second. Pollock on at first with two down. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
The full count offering. And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away.
Finally. Up to this point, the entire lineup had been swinging at anything close, and this guy decides to show a little more patience at the dish and is rewarded with a base on balls. That was a good at-bat.
Here now is Will Smith, one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Base is juiced now with two away. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. This side is... And that'll bring in Charlie Blackmon. His lifetime numbers against Kershaw. He's got an even 20 hits in 68 at-bats. Also of note, the 4 home runs he's hit against him. And there's a base hit on the line. And a relay home. And he is going to beat the throw home as he scores to make this a 5-3 game now. And he'll get in there safely.
You love the aggressive base running right there. It's not easy.
Now at the plate, A.J. Pollock singled in his last at-bat. Swing and a hot shot toward third. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Well, Dan, the sun goes down and this guy lights up right here. That's his third knock of the night.
Talk about having a good night. 3 hits and, hey, he might have another at-bat or two before this one ends.
Now back, second baseman.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. Runner at first here, one man out.
One away.
Swing and a little tapper. Here's another 2-2. Here's a look over to first. Thought about going for second, but instead, now they've got him in a pickle.
Decisions like that have to be made knowing who you've got at the plate. This guy can...
Hey, let's go right here.
Now to the plate. Here is number 9. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Pulled high in the air out to left field. On the move is Pollock. He gets there, and that's the second out. now into the box is
A.J. Pollock.
He's got three hits, including a double to this point. First pitch on its way. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble.
You got to make the turn.
He's around first, heading for two.
Eat it, eat it.
And he'll pull into second with his fourth hit of the ball game.
You don't get too many pitches a day in the big leagues, middle cut. His eyes lit up right there. This pitcher's lucky he's not getting another ball from the umpire.
Robert Stevenson is into the ball game now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. Rogers picks it up. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Two-out double left stranded. The three of us return with more Wednesday Night Baseball after this. Now it'll be Charlie Blackmon, two for three with a double on his line so far. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Pollock has a read on it, one away.
Yeah, they needed him a little bit earlier in this one, but he takes the mound in the eighth and records the final four outs. Four out save, job well done.
And tonight's comes to an end, 6-3 the final. The Rockies took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Austin Gomber earns the win, his second. Clayton Kershaw struggled and gets the loss after giving up six earned. Scott Oberg gets a four-out save, his fourth of the season. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ballgame tonight for the victorious Rockies.